Andrea, hvala za scripture reading, za biblijski
Andrea,
tekst koji si nam čitala.
Thank you for the scripture reading that you did so well.
Za vas koji niste razumeli, to je 137. psalam.
For those of you who didn't understand, the scripture today is Psalm 137.
Od prvog do četvrtog stiha.
From the first to the fourth verse.
Vidjet ćete da bi za svakoga od vas ko danas ima Bibliju, dobro bilo da ima otvorenu Bibliju na ovom mestu.
And you'll see that all of you who have your Bibles today, it'll be good to follow along in your Bibles.
137 i prva četiri stiha.
Psalm 137, the first four verses.
Naslov moje propovedi danas mogli ste da vidite u bulletinu.
The title of my sermon today, you could see it in the bulletin.
Harfe, Vavilon i Sion.
Harps, Babylon and Zion.
Ja nisam bio na tromesečnom rasporedu da danas propovedam, ja zamenjujem onoga koji je trebalo i koji je ima problem sa zdravljem.
I'm filling in for the pastor who is not feeling well.
Ja se nadam da će dovoljno ozdraviti kad dođe moj red u februaru da će onda on mene zameniti.
I'm hoping that if I ever need a substitute he will be willing to jump in.
Ja se nadam da niste čuli puno propovedi na temu iz Psalma 137, 1 do 4.
I hope that you haven't heard very many sermons based on Psalm 137.
Što se mene tiče,
as far as I'm concerned,
već u dobroj starosti ja po prvi put propovedam na ovu temu.
In my old age, this is the first time that I'm preaching on this psalm.
Nikada ranije nisam propovedao o ovome što piše u 137. psalmu.
I've never preached on this psalm before.
Psalmi su u stvari pesme.
Psalms, in fact, are songs or hymns.
I pevale su se na službama u hramu.
And these hymns were sung at temple services.
I za specijalne jevrijske praznike.
And for special Jewish festivities, holidays.
Svakako, 137. psalam zbog svog sadržaja nije lak da se peva kao pesma.
And because of its content, which is pretty bleak and difficult, Psalm 137 doesn't lend itself to singing, to good singing.
Autor ovog psalma je zvanično nepoznat. Ne zna se ko je pisao 137. psalam.
The author of this psalm is officially unknown. We're not sure who wrote it.
Rabini nam daju ideju da bi to mogao biti prorok Jeremija.
The old Jewish rabbis give us an idea. They speculate that this could be Jeremiah.
Tako u prevodu Septuaginte 137. psalam ima naslov.
So in the Septuaginta translation, this psalm has a title.
I naslov je Za Davida od Jeremije u ropstvu.
And the title is For David from Jeremiah in Exile.
Da idemo na psalam.
So let's go through the psalm now.
Prvi stih.
The first verse.
Na vodama vavilonskim seđasmo i plakasmo, opominjući se Siona.
By the rivers of Babylon we sat and wept when we remembered Zion.
Psalam je pesma.
A psalm is a song.
Ova pesma je vrlo nezgodna da se peva.
This song is very awkward to sing.
Na vodama vavilonskim seđasmo i plakasmo opominjući se Siona.
By the rivers of Babylon we sat and wept when we remembered Zion.
Vavilonske vode.
The rivers of Babylon.
Bar dve velike reke su tekle u blizini ili kroz srce Vavilona.
Two big rivers ran around or in the center of Babylon.
To je reka Eufrat koja je tekla kroz srce grada.
The Euphrates that ran through the heart of the city.
Biblijski historičari tvrde da su Vavilonjani u poljima izvan grada Vavilona sagradili velike sisteme kanala iz kojih se voda koristila za navodnjavanje.
The scholars, the Bible scholars claim that the Babylonians built a whole system of water channels or aqueducts that ran through the city.
Bilo je mnogo vavilonskih voda.
There was a lot of Babylonian rivers.
I vode su bile svuda okolo gde su Judejci kao robovi radili i gledali vodu svakoga dana.
The water was all around the Jews who worked as slaves in the fields, and they looked at those waters every day.
Ali ovde na vodama vavilonskim sede Judejci i plaču.
But here by the rivers of Babylon, the Jews sit and weep.
Sam izraz seđa smo i plaka smo je vrlo čudan i stran i tužan za jednog Judejca.
The term itself, sitting and weeping, is foreign for a Jew.
To je bedna slika naročito za Judejca.
It's a tragic picture for a Jew.
Jer Judejac nije voleo da sedi i da plače.
For Jews did not like to sit and weep.
On je voleo da stoji i da peva i da podskakuje od radosti.
The Jews like to stand up and sing and dance.
I samo njihovo ime koje potiče od Jude ima značenje pesme i radosti.
Their name, Jews, are derived from Judah, which means joy. Yeah. That has some dancing and joy in the name itself.
Originalna jevrejska reč Jehuda u stvari u prevodu na naš jezik kaže radost i pesma.
The original Hebrew word for Judah is joy and song.
Kad je Judu rodila Lija, jedna od Jakovljevih majki, ona mu je dala ime Jehuda i u stvari je rekla sad ću ja da proslavljam Gospoda.
So when Leah, one of Jacob's wives, gave birth to Judah, when she gave birth to him, she named him Judah, which means now I will praise the Lord.
Ako biste danas tražili slično ime u našoj kulturi, u našem jeziku za Judu, to bi bio Slavko.
If you were looking for the equivalent of this in our language, it would be Slavko, Mary, maybe Gloriana.
Jedan Slavko je bio kod nas, ali ga više nema, otpratili smo ga.
We had a Slavko among us, and he's not with us anymore.
Imamo još jednog i pozdravite ga, nije u crkvi, i kažite mu šta znači njegovo ime.
We have another, he's not with us today. If you see him, say hello to him from us and tell him that we miss him.
Ali ovde je vrlo duboka poruka. U ovom tekstu sedi i plače Judejac.
But there's a deep meaning, a deep message in this verse.
Juda je trebalo da peva i nikada ne sedi.
A Jew sitting and crying. A Jew who was not supposed to sit and cry, but stand up and dance.
Jer Juda nikada nije sedeo i pevao.
Judah never sat and sang.
Te dve stvari nisu nikada išle zajedno.
Those two things never went together. They don't match.
Za njega pevanje znači stajanje.
For a Jew, singing means standing.
Ali ovde Judejac sedi i plače. Ako sedi, onda znači treba da plače. Ako stoji, onda znači treba da peva.
But here a Jew is sitting and crying.
Judejac nikada nije sedeo i pevao, on je jedino mogao da sedi i da plače.
A Jew never sat and sang. He could only sit and cry.
Ali ovde na vavilonskim vodama je još nešto neobično.
But here by the rivers of Babylon there's one more thing that's peculiar.
To je drugi stih.
And it's verse 2.
O vrbama sred njega veša smo harfe svoje.
There on the poplars or willows we hung our harps.
I ovaj stih još više kazuje da nema pevanja.
And this verse shows us one more time that there is no singing.
Zato što su vrbe zato što su harfe odložene na vrbe.
Because the harps are hung on the willow branches.
Za Judejca harfi je mesto u rukama sa prstima.
For a Jew, the harp should be handheld, played with.
Ako harfa nije u ruci, to znači da nešto nije u redu.
If the harp is not in their hands, that means that something is wrong.
Harfa ide sa pesmom, sa radošću, sa proslavljanjem.
The harp goes with singing, with praising, with joy.
Ovde ima jedan mali problem, ako zamislite današnju klasičnu harfu, ona je prevelika za ovu situaciju na Vavilonskim vodama.
So the modern harp is unlike these harps that are mentioned here. If you are imagining the harp that we have today, the modern harp is too big to be hung on a tree.
Ona ne može da visi ni na jednoj grani.
The modern harp would not be hanging from any willow tree.
Jevrejska originalna reč ovde upotrebljena se najčešće prevodi u mnogim jezicima sa lirom.
Therefore, the original Hebrew word here that we use for harp is often translated into the lyre.
So, lira je mala verzija harfe na neki način.
So the lyre is a much smaller version of the harp.
Ona je čak manja i od obične klasične gitare.
It's even smaller than a regular classical guitar.
Ali ona ima isto tako svoje žice i uglavnom su je Judejci imali kao svoj lični, vrlo pokretljivi instrument.
But this instrument is also a string instrument. It's got strings, and it's small enough to be carried around.
Dakle, Judejci koji su se spakovali i koji su emigrirali u Vavilon, pokupili su svoje lire.
So the Jews who went into exile to Babylon carried their harps with them to Babylon.
Osim svojih kesi i torbi, lira je bila isto tako prikačena na ramenu i Judejac je išao sa lirom kroz život.
Other than their other luggage that they carried to Babylon, their harps were also with them.
Lira, čije se žice ovde na Vavilonskim vodama ne mogu oglasiti.
This was a lyre whose strings were not to be played on the rivers of Babylon.
Zamislite Judejce koji sede pored vode.
Imagine the Jews who were sitting by the water.
Ovaj motiv, ova slika je bila ideja za mnoge umetnike.
This motif was an idea for many artists.
Možete da vidite mnoge slike koje prikazuju ovu scenu, stare slike iz prošlih vekova.
You can see a lot of ancient paintings that depict this scene.
I mnogi muzičari su pevali o jevrejskom roblju na Vavilonskim vodama.
And many musicians also composed on this motif, on this theme.
Ono što je zanimljivo u ova prva dva stiha, pa i kasnije u sledeća dva, ovde se spominju dva grada.
What's interesting about this text, and this is mentioned in the first verse and the next few verses, is the mention of two cities.
Babylon i Jerusalim.
And Jerusalem.
Jerusalim spomenut kao Sion u prvom stihu.
Jerusalem, aka Zion, in the first verse.
Na vodama Vavilonskim seđa smo i plaka smo, opominjući se Siona. Dva grada se ovde spominju u jednom istom stihu, jedan pored drugog.
In this first verse, these two cities are mentioned side by side, Babylon and Zion.
Cela Biblija je u znaku dva grada, Vavilona i Siona, odnosno Jerusalima.
And as a matter of fact, the whole Bible carries on this idea of two cities, Babylon and Jerusalem.
Dva grada koja su apsolutno potpuno suprotna.
The two cities are completely different, completely the opposite of each other.
Ali nekom čudnom magnetskom silom uvijek su jedan pored drugog.
But by some mysterious magnetic force, they're always side by side.
Tako i ovdje u ovom našem stihu.
And so it is in this first verse.
Babilon je đavolski grad.
Babylon is the devil's city.
Jerusalim je sveti Božji grad.
Jerusalem is the holy city of God.
U Babilonu je presto zla.
And Babylon, there is the throne of evil.
U Jerusalimu je presto svetlosti.
Jerusalem is the throne of svetlosti, light.
Light. I naš psalam danas nam kaže da je Božji narod transportovan iz Jerusalima u Babilon.
And our text today tells us that God's chosen people were transported from Zion to Babylon.
I u Babilonu imamo one koji porobljuju, porobljivače, a imamo i porobljene.
And there in Babylon we see the captors and the captives.
I jedni i drugi su prisutni.
They're both present.
I vrlo su blizu jedni drugih.
And they're very close to each other here.
Porobljivači ovdje u trećem stihu se pojavljuju.
The captors or the conquerors appear in verse 3.
I šta oni rade?
And what do they do?
Kaže treći stih. Onda iskahu koji nas zarobiše da pevamo i koji nas oboriše da se veselimo. Pevajte nam sionsku pesmu.
It says in verse 3, for there our captors asked us for songs. Our tormentors demanded songs of joy. They said, sing us one of the songs of Zion.
Ovo mora da bude jako bolno za Judejca.
This must have been very painful for a Jew.
Koji sedi i plače.
Who is sitting and weeping.
Čija je harfa obešena na granu.
Whose harp is hung on the branch of the willow.
A dolazi Babilonjanin i kaže, pevajte nam vašu sionsku pesmu.
And a Babylonian comes and tells him, sing us your songs of Zion.
I onda sledi završni tekst za naše današnje proučavanje.
And then the final verse that we're going to stop at today.
Pitanje.
A question.
Ne samo za ono vreme, nego i za dan danas.
Not only for those times, but for our times as well.
I ono predstavlja duboki duhovni problem s kojim se suočava čak i danas Judejac, Božje dete.
And this question that's asked here poses a great problem even for the Jews today, God's chosen people today.
Kako ćemo pevati pesmu Gospodnju u zemlji tuđoj?
How can we sing the songs of the Lord while in a foreign land?
Ja bih volio da budete sa mnom zato što ćemo ići sada u simbole i u suštinu.
I'd like you to stay with me now because we're going to look further in the symbols and the core of this.
Ako smo zaista Judejci, Božja deca.
If we truly are the Jews or God's chosen people.
I tužno zarobljeni u Babilonu ovoga sveta i greha.
And exiled into the Babylon of this world.
Pitanje je za nas.
This is a question for us.
Kako mogu da pevam u zemlji tuđoj?
How can I sing in a foreign land?
Kako da pevam na vodama vavilonskim?
How can I sing on the rivers of by the rivers of Babylon?
Kako da uzmem liru i da svojim prstima oslobađam iz lire divne zvuke?
How can I pick up my lyre and run my fingers across the strings to make music?
A Vavilonjani se rugaju.
And the Babylonians are taunting.
Mi to dobro znamo.
We know this really well.
Dragi moji, na vodama vavilonskim ima suza.
My dear brothers and sisters, on the rivers of Babylon there are many tears.
Na vavilonskim vodama ima jako mnogo suza.
But the rivers of Babylon there are many tears.
I vi to dobro znate.
And you know this really well.
I ja to dobro znam.
And I know this really well.
I ponekad ne možemo da zamislimo kako lira i tuga mogu da idu zajedno.
And sometimes we can't imagine how lyres and songs, tears can go hand in hand.
Vavilonjani su likovali, oni su triumfovali.
The Babylonians were likovali, triumphed, cheered.
I ponižavali su Judejca i njihovog Boga i kazali su, ajde pevajte nam pesme vašega Boga.
And they belittled, they humiliated the Jews by asking them to sing the songs of Zion.
A u minijaturi imamo jedan detalj iz istorije izraelskog naroda mnogo ranije.
And we have an example of this many years before this in the history of the Jewish people.
Samson je bio dugokosi momak jevrejske rase.
Samson was a long-haired boy of the Jewish origin.
On je bio Božji izbor.
He was God's choice.
I narodni heroj.
And a national hero.
Ali on je pao.
But he fell.
Sapleo se o šta?
He tripped on what?
O Filistejca?
He tripped on a Philistine?
To bi bilo pogrešno.
That would be wrong answer.
O pogrešnu ženu za koju se vezao, čak bi i to bilo pogrešno.
Did he trip on a wrong woman that he acquainted himself with? That
Samson,
would be the wrong answer
Samson
also.
Se sapleo o svoj lični greh.
Samson, what tripped Samson was his own personal sin.
U suštini, to je pravi zaključak.
And actually, that is the correct conclusion.
I oni su ga uhvatili.
So he was captured.
I oni su ga vezali.
And they tied him up.
I oni su mu iskopali oči.
And they took his eyes out.
I dali su mu da radi posao koji je u to vreme u toj kulturi jedino žena radila.
And they gave him a job that was only done by women back in those times.
Čitajte u Sudijama.
You can read about this in the Judges.
I onda Sudije 16. poglavlje od 23. do 25. stiha opisuje tu tragediju jednog Judejca koji je meta ruganja Filistejaca.
And in the Judges 16 chapter 23 to 25, there's a description of this tragedy.
Hoćete da se podsjetimo na taj stih?
Samson.
Pogledajte još jedno, vi to znate, ali gledajte koliko je to tužno i jadno i bedno.
You know this text, but let's read it again. Let's remind ourselves of how tragic this was.
Sudije 16,
23.
I knezovi filistejski skupiše se da prinesu veliku žrtvu Dagonu, Bogu svojemu.
Now the rulers of the Philistines assembled to offer a great sacrifice to Dagon, their god, and to celebrate.
Pa rekoše, predade nam Bog naš u ruke naše Samsona, neprijatelja našega. Gledajte tu igru bogova.
Saying, our God has delivered Samson, our enemy, into our hands.
Takođe i narod, videvši ga, hvaljaše Boga svojega, govoreći.
When the people saw him, they praised their God, saying,
predade nam Bog naš u ruke naše, neprijatelja našega, i zatirača zemlje naše, i koji pobi tolike između nas.
Our God has delivered our enemy into our hands, the one who laid waste our land and multiplied our slain.
I onda 25. stih.
And then the 25th verse.
I kad se razveseli srce njihovo, rekoše.
While they were in high spirits, they shouted,
zovite Samsona, i šta piše dalje?
Bring out Samson, and then what does it say?
Da nam igra.
To entertain us.
Kako može Izraeljac da igra pred Filistejcima?
How can a Jew dance in front of the Philistines?
I dozvavše Samsona iz tamnice da im igra.
So they call Samson out of the prison.
I namestiše ga između dva stuba.
And he performed for them when they stood him among the pillars.
Ja verujem da je u ovim trenucima duboko u srcu Samsona bilo pitanje kako da igram u zemlji tuđoj.
I believe that at this point in deep in the heart of Samson there was a question, how can I how can I dance for these people?
Još uvijek smo kod tog teškog pitanja kako da pevamo u zemlji tuđoj.
We're still at the same difficult question, how can we sing in a foreign land?
Pesme sionske se ne slažu sa vodama vavilonskim.
The songs of Zion don't go along with the rivers of Babylon.
S jedne strane, mi, deca Božja, ne osjećamo se dobro u Vavilonu.
On one hand, we don't feel well on the rivers of Babylon. As God's children, we don't feel well
mi
in Babylon.
Mi smo stranci u tuđoj zemlji.
We're strangers in a foreign land.
Neko je rekao,
someone said,
samo Vavilonjanin može da se osjeća dobro u Vavilonu.
Only a Babylonian can feel well in Babylon.
Da li je tako?
Is this so?
Svi mi ostali kao deca Božja nosimo Sion, Jerusalim u našem srcu.
The rest of us as God's children carry Zion in our hearts.
I imamo problem da uzmemo liru, harfu u ruke.
And we have a problem with picking up the harp.
Rađe bismo odložili liru za bolja vremena.
We would much rather set aside our harps for better times.
Okačili ograne, seli i plakali.
We would much rather hang our harps on the branches and sit and weep.
A za Božju decu ima mnogo suza u Vavilonu.
But for God's children there are many tears in Babylon.
S druge strane, ja lično verujem da postoji jedan koji voli da mi odložimo naše lire.
On the other hand, I believe that there is one who wants us to set down our harps.
I on bi vjerovatno voleo jako da uživa kad nas gleda da sedimo na vodama vavilonskim i da plačemo.
And he would very much enjoy watching us sit on the banks of the rivers of Babylon.
On nas možda ne može navesti da se drogiramo.
He might not lead us into temptation to take drugs.
Ili da se opijamo.
Or to drink alcohol,
ili da se predamo razvratu,
or to turn ourselves over to a lustful, sinful life.
Ali će biti vrlo srećan ako uspe da nas navede da odložimo naše harfe.
But he will be quite happy to make us put down our harps.
I da sedimo pokraj vavilonskih voda i da plačemo.
And watch us sit on the by the rivers of Babylon and cry.
Ja imam vrlo teško i tužno pitanje za sebe u svom srcu.
I have a very difficult and a very painful question for myself in my heart.
Koliki su oni koji su ovde bili i sedeli sa nama?
How many among us, those who used to sit here with us,
koji su pevali pesme sionske sa harfama u rukama,
those who used to sing the songs of Zion with their harps in their hands,
kako su mogli da odu odavde i da im je dobro u Vavilonu?
How could they leave this place and feel good in Babylon?
Imam jedini odgovor.
I have one answer.
Ili im Sion nije nikada bio 100% u srcu.
Either Zion was never fully in their hearts.
Ili je bio pa su ga zaboravili.
Or it was, but they forgot it.
A pozitivno kod roblja na vodama vavilonskim je u 5. i 6. stihu 137. psalma.
But for sure, kod roblja, among the captives, in Babylon,
137, 5. i 6.
Psalm 137, 5th and 6th verse.
Ako zaboravim tebe, Jerusalime, neka me zaboravi desnica moja.
If I forget you, O Jerusalem, may my right hand forget its skill.
Neka prione jezik moj za usta moja, ako tebe ne uspamtim.
May my tongue cling to the roof of my mouth if I do not remember you.
Ako ne uzdržim Jerusalima svih veselja svojih.
If I do not consider Jerusalem my highest joy.
Ono što treba da bude, braćo moje, naš cilj, to je da nastavimo da sedimo na vavilonskim vodama, ali da neki način pronađemo razlog da živimo u Sionu.
What should be our goal, brothers and sisters, is to continue to sit on the banks of the rivers of Babylon, but to find a reason to Da sedimo na vodama i da šta?
I da ipak držimo Sion u srcu.
And to still keep Zion in our hearts.
Da sedimo na vodama vavilonskim, ali da nam harfa ne bude odložena.
To sit by the rivers of Babylon, but not put down our harps.
To je priličan izazov za nas.
That's quite a challenge for us.
Možeš li da sediš na vavilonskim vodama gde su suze, a da ipak imaš radost u srcu sa Bogom, da imaš sionsku radost?
Can you sit on the rivers of Babylon, by the rivers of Babylon, and still keep the joy of Zion in your heart?
Da sediš na vavilonskim vodama, ali da ti Sion bude u srcu.
Can you sit by the rivers of Babylon, but carry Zion in your heart?
To podrazumeva odluke u našem životu.
This means bringing certain decisions in our lives.
Čitam o devojci, tinejdžerki koja je imala sastanak sa mladićem.
And there's a story about a young lady, a teenager who had a date with a young man.
Nije ni znala da je taj mladić napravio jedan prljavi plan.
She wasn't aware of his plan. He made a plan.
On je angažovao još jedan par devojke i mladića.
He made plans with another couple, another young man and a young woman.
I ona je odjednom razumela da je za jedan takav sastanak isplanirano i piće i droga i sve ostalo vrlo ružno što ide s tim.
And pretty quickly she discovered that this plan included drugs and drinks and all kinds of other stuff that went with that.
I devojka hrišćanka odjedan put se našla u toj situaciji.
And this young Christian woman found herself in this situation all of a sudden.
Pogledala je u mladića i kazala je.
She looked at her date and she said,
ako ti hoćeš da se uključiš u ove aktivnosti,
if you want to participate in these activities,
prvo moraš mene da odvedeš kući.
You'll have to take me home first.
Jedna osoba uključena u društvo je pogledala u devojku i postavila pitanje.
And one of the other people in the group looked at the young lady and asked a question.
U čemu je problem?
What's the problem?
Da li se možda bojiš da će te tvoj otac povrediti kad bude čuo gde si bila i šta si radila?
Are you afraid that your dad might hurt you if he finds out where you were and what you did?
Ja volim njen odgovor.
I like her response.
Ne, ja se ne bojim da će me otac povrediti.
No, I'm not afraid that my father will hurt me.
Ja se bojim da ću ja da povredim mog oca.
I'm afraid that I will hurt my father.
I ima razlike u ovom.
And there's a difference in this.
Da li znate zašto ima toliko onih koji se zovu hrišćani?
Do you know why there are so many of those who claim to be called Christians?
I koji žive u grehu.
And they live in sin.
I nikada ne proliju ni jednu suzu zbog toga.
And they never shed a single tear because of this.
Zašto?
Why?
Zato što su zaboravili Sion.
Because they forgot Zion.
Oni možda i nikada nisu bili u Sionu za stvarno.
Maybe they were never truly in Zion.
Oni ne mogu da se sete šta znači hodati sa Bogom.
They can't remember what it means to walk with God.
Jer verovatno u stvarnosti nikada nisu ni hodali sa Bogom.
For in reality they never really walked with God.
Zašto mnogi napuštaju crkvu?
Why do so many leave the church?
Jedan razlog, bojim se da je najveći i najčešći.
One of the reasons, and I'm afraid it's the biggest and the most often.
Nikada nisu ni pripadali crkvi svojim srcem.
They never belong to the church with their heart.
Apostol Jovan u prvoj svojoj poslanici u drugom poglavlju u 19. stihu daje jednu formulu za one koji odlaze od crkve.
The apostle John in one of his epistles gives a formula for those who leave the church.
Znate kako glasi ta formula?
What is the formula?
1. Jovana 2:19.
1 John 2:19.
Jovan kaže, od nas iziđoše, ali ne behu od nas.
John says, they went out from us, but they did not really belong to us.
Oni su otišli od nas, ali u stvari nikada nisu pripadali nama.
They left from us, but they never really belonged to us.
To je neobično, to je teško.
It's unusual and difficult to grasp.
To je loša situacija i teška definicija.
This is a very difficult definition and a bad situation.
U stvari, šta nas čini robovima u Vavilonu? Mi trebamo, braćo i sestre, pravi odgovor na ovo pitanje.
What actually makes us the captives in Babylon? We need the right answer to this question.
Ovi u 137. psalmu koji su sedeli na vavilonskim vodama.
Those who sat by the rivers of Babylon in Psalm 137.
Da li su imali pravi odgovor ko je u stvari njih zarobio?
Did they have the right answer to their question of who their real captors were?
Nabuchodonosor?
Nebuchadnezzar?
To bi bio površan i pogrešan odgovor.
That would be a superficial and the wrong answer.
Neprijatelji? Vojnici?
Enemies, soldiers?
U stvari, njihov greh je njih zarobio.
In fact, it was their sin that kept them captives.
To je zarobilo Judejce.
That's what captured the Jews.
Ako se osjećaš zarobljenim,
if you feel captured,
i ne možeš da pevaš,
and you can sing,
i svoju liru si okačio o granu,
and you hung your lyre on the branch,
pravi razlog za to treba da tražiš u svom grehu.
The real reason, you should look for the real reason in your own sin.
Mi smo skloni da razlog tražimo u drugome.
We tend to look for reasons in others.
I mi kažemo, kako da pevam kad me je brat u crkvi povredio?
And we say, how can I sing when my brother at church hurt me?
Kako da pevam kad su me moja deca ranila?
How can I sing when my children wounded me?
Kako da pevam i da sviram na mojoj liri kad mi moj muž ili moja žena priređuje pakao u kući?
How can I sing and play my lyre when my husband at home makes it a living hell for me?
Sve su to pogrešni odgovori.
Those are all wrong answers.
U krajnjoj liniji, ono što nas najefikasnije zarobljava, to je naš lični greh.
The bottom line is captures us, what enslaves us, is our own sin.
Mene ne zarobljava tvoj greh, brate i sestro.
I'm not enslaved by your sin.
Ja sam zarobljen samo mojim ličnim grehom.
I'm enslaved by my own sin alone.
I ja ne mogu tebe da zarobim onim što ja radim.
And I can't enslave you with the things I do.
Žalosno je da mnogi kažu ne mogu više u toj crkvi jer ne mogu da podnesem tog pastora.
It's very sad when some say I can't go to that church anymore because I can't stand that pastor.
Ja ne mogu te ljude u tom odboru više da zamislim niti da ih gledam.
I can't stand those people in the church on the church board anymore.
U toj crkvi ima mnogo licemera i mnogo onih koji nisu obraćeni.
There's a lot of people in that church who are hypocrites and they're not truly converted.
I onda ja moram da sedim na vodama vavilonskim i da plačem.
And so I have to sit on the banks of the Babylonian rivers and cry.
Mi treba da donesemo odluku da pronađemo pravi razlog za naše zarobljeništvo.
We have to bring a decision to find the real reason for our captivity.
Judejci su se našli u Vavilonu zbog svojih ličnih greha, a ne zbog grubosti Nabukodonosora.
The Jews found themselves captured in Babylon not because of the cruelty of Nebuchadnezzar, but because of their own sins.
Da li znate, kad čitate proroka Jeremiju, da je Bog poslao Nabukodonosora da pokupi te Judejce i da ih dovede na vode Vavilonske?
When you read Jeremiah's texts, you will find out that God sent Nebuchadnezzar to go get the Jews and bring them into Babylon.
Jeremija 25. poglavlje, čitajte kod kuće.
Jeremiah 25th chapter, read it at home.
Prorok kaže, 23 godine ja sam vas stalno zvao i opominjao da se pokajete.
The prophet says, for 23 years I called you and I asked you to repent.
I onda od 9. do 11. stiha, nećemo to čitati, prorok Jeremija kaže Judejcima, ali me niste poslušali.
But verses 9 to 11, Jeremiah says, but you did not listen.
Kad smo srušeni,
when we're knocked down,
Kad sedimo kod voda vavilonskih,
when we're sitting by the Babylonian rivers,
uglavnom zaključujemo pogrešne, a ne glavne razloge za to.
We conclude most of the time we conclude the wrong, we come to the wrong conclusions.
To je neko drugi.
It's someone else.
Zbog koga ja ne mogu da budem srećan.
Someone else who is responsible for my happiness.
To je neko iz crkve, to su naše deca, to su naši roditelji.
Someone from church, it's our kids, it's our parents.
To su oni koji su nas povredili.
It's those who hurt us.
To su oni koji su nas ranili da ne možemo da pevamo.
Those who wounded us and caused us to not be able to sing.
Mi smo odložili naše harfe zbog onoga što su nam drugi uradili.
We put our harps away because of what others did to us.
Braćo moje i sestre,
my dear brothers and
naš
sisters,
greh je prvi i najglavniji uzrok za robovanje.
Our sin is the first and the only reason for our captivity.
Za plakanje i za suze.
It's the only thing that's responsible for our crying and our tears.
Kad okrenemo list i dođemo u Novi Zavet,
when we get to the New Testament, when we turn the page and get to the New Testament,
onda dolazimo do jedinog i pravog rešenja za naše tužno sedenje na vavilonskim vodama.
We get to the real and the only solution for our crying on the Babylonian rivers.
Jedino u njemu je rešenje.
Only in him we have the solution.
Vi znate o kome govorim.
You know who I'm talking about.
To je naš Gospod Isus Hristos.
It's our Lord Jesus Christ.
On jedini može da nas dovede u tako neprirodnu situaciju da sedimo u tami i da pevamo.
Only he can bring us into an unnatural situation of sitting in the darkness and singing.
Pavle i Sila sede u kraj vodama vavilonskim u zatvoru u Filipi.
Paul and Silas are sitting by the Babylonian rivers in prison in
Njihovi zglobovi na rukama su bili otečeni, njihove noge su bile otečene i šta rade Pavle i Sila u zatvoru?
Their arms and legs were swollen and what are they doing?
Možeš da sediš na vavilonskim vodama i da pevaš.
It's possible to sit by the rivers of Babylon and sing.
Ljudi će da kažu to nije prirodno, ti nisi normalan.
People are going to say that's not natural. You don't know what you're talking about.
I da vam kažem da neko sedi na vavilonskim vodama i da peva mora da bude nenormalan.
And let me tell you, for someone to be sitting by the Babylonian rivers and sing, that is unnatural.
Po svim merilima sveta i Vavilona.
By all means.
Jedna ilustracija vrlo lepa. Pri kraju smo.
There is a beautiful illustration.
Adoniram Gordon.
Adoniram Gordon.
Veliki propovednik, pisac, kompozitor.
A great preacher, writer, and composer.
Osnivač teološkog seminara priča svoje lično životno iskustvo.
The founder of a theologian seminary tells one of his one of the events from his own life.
Neki od vas znate za to.
Some of you may know this story.
Ali budite fini prema meni pa slušajte kao da prvi put slušate.
But be patient and listen to it again.
A ja ću da ponovim.
And I will tell it again.
Propovednik Gordon je krenuo u šetnju jednog popodneva.
So Pastor Gordon went out for a walk one afternoon.
Ovo je njegov stvarni doživljaj.
This is a real event from his life.
Video je bosog dečaka sa strašno zamazanim i prljavim licem.
And he came across a boy, a barefoot boy. The boy had a dirty face, very dirty face.
U rukama je nosio porđali kavez za ptice.
And in his hands the boy was carrying rusty bird cage.
I u tom kavezu su bili neki obični vrapci.
And in this bird cage there were some very plain looking sparrows.
Gordon, poznat po svojoj ljubavi prema prirodi,
Pastor Gordon, who was a great nature lover,
zaustavio je malog dečaka i pitao ga,
stopped the little boy and asked him,
gde si našao te ptice?
Where did you find these birds?
Dečak je odgovorio, Uhvatio sam ih zamkom koju sam napravio.
And the boy answered, I trapped them. I made a trap and I trapped them.
I šta planiraš da radiš sa tim vrapcima?
And what are you going to do with these sparrows?
Ne znam, to, valjda ću malo da se igram sa njima.
I don't know, I'm just going to play with them for a while.
Dobro, a šta ćeš posle toga da radiš sa njima?
All right, but what are you going to do with them afterwards?
Pa, ja planiram u stvari da ih ubijem.
Well, actually, I think I'm just going to kill them.
A da li bih hteo da ih prodaš?
Would you want to sell them to me?
Dečak je bio šokiran, pogledao je u Gordona i kazao.
The boy was surprised, stunned, and he looked at Pastor Gordon and he said,
Gospodine, zar bi ti ili iko drugi bio zainteresovan da kupi ovakve vrapce?
Sir, would you actually be interested in purchasing these sparrows?
Pa to su mali, obični divlji vrapci.
These are just plain regular wild sparrows.
Gordon je kazao, ja znam šta su ti vrapci.
And Gordon said, I know what these birds are.
Samo ja te pitam da li hoćeš da ih prodaš.
I'm just asking you, would you like to sell them to me?
Dečak je odgovorio,
the boy answered,
a šta bi mi ti dao za njih?
Well, what are you gonna give me for them?
I sad imajte na umu da je Gordon živeo i radio u 19. veku.
So keep in mind, Gordon lived in the 19th century.
On kaže, daću ti $2.
And he said, I'll give you $2.
Tada su to bile dobre pare.
Back
za
then, that
vrapce.
Was a lot of money for plain sparrows.
Dečak je bio iskren i šokiran, kaže, jeste vi normalni, gospodine?
The boy was stunned. He was surprised and he said, are you all right? Are you thinking clearly?
Gordon kaže, ne, ja sam ozbiljan.
And Gordon said, yes, I'm serious.
Ja ću ti dati $2.
I will give you $2 for
them. A onda dečak kaže, ako ćeš mi dati $2, ja ću ti dati i kavez i vrapce.
And the boy said, if you're going to give me $2, I will give you the birds and the bird cage.
Jako mi pažljivo slušate, jako ste fini, a vi znate ovu priču.
Listen carefully. I know you know this story, but you're kind to pay attention.
Gordon je konačno kazao, hvala ti, sine.
And finally Gordon said, thank you, son.
Hvala ti.
Thank you.
I onda taj veliki pastor AJ Gordon je uzeo kavez pun uplašenih običnih vrabaca.
And then Pastor Gordon, the great preacher, took this cage with a bunch of scared little sparrows.
Zastao za trenutak dok dečak nije otišao sa svoja $2.
He paused for a moment until the boy left with his money.
Ušao u jednu sporednu ulicu.
He went into one of the side streets
gde ga niko nije gledao,
where no one could see him.
Otvorio je vrata na tom zaređalom kavezu.
He opened the gate, the door to the little
unutra su bili uplašeni vrapci.
And inside were these scared little sparrows.
I onda je počeo prstima da udara u dno zaređalog kaveza.
And then he started rattling the bottom of the cage with his hand.
I Gordon priča svoju životnu priču. Gledao je kako su jadni i uplašeni vrapci jedan za drugim dolazili na otvorena vrata kaveza zarđalog.
And then Pastor Gordon tells his story, continues his story to describe the sparrows coming to the door of the bird cage.
I dolazili na vrata otvorena.
They were coming to the open door of the cage.
Počeli da šire svoje mala krila.
They were starting to spread their little wings.
I odletali jedan za drugim.
And fly away.
Završava Gordon svoju istinitu priču time kako je gledao te vrapce kako odleću.
And he concludes his story with this scene of watching the birds fly away.
Podizali su se sve više i više.
They were flying higher and higher.
Crkutali.
And they chirped.
I kako su se podizali, pravili su sve veće i veće krugove u vazduhu.
And as they were going higher and higher, they were making larger circles in the sky.
I počeli su da pevaju svoju pesmu slobode.
And they started singing their song of freedom.
Koju nisu pevali u zarđalom kavezu.
Which they were not singing in the rusted birdcage.
I propovednik Gordon završava priču.
And Pastor Gordon finishes his story.
Nekako kao da sam razumeo reči te pesme tih vrabaca.
I felt as if I understood what they were singing, what the sparrows were singing.
Otkupljeni, otkupljeni, otkupljeni.
Redeemed, redeemed, redeemed.
Ovo treba da bude moja i tvoja pesma.
There should be my and mine and your song.
dok sedimo na vodama Vavilonskim.
While we're sitting on the rivers of Babylon.
Otkupitelj je platio cenu.
The Redeemer paid the price.
I uzeo naš zarđeli kavez greha.
And took our rusty cage of sin.
Otvorio ga i dunuo slobodu u našu dušu.
He opened it and he blew the breath of freedom into our souls.
Ti i ja smo svakako bivši robovi greha.
You and I are certainly the captors of sin.
Naši greha.
Our own sin.
Moji greha.
My sin.
Tvojih greha.
Your sin.
Isus je dao svoju krv ne samo da nas spasi od kazne greha.
Jesus gave his precious blood not only to save us from the punishment of sin.
On je dao svoju bezgrešnu skupocenu krv.
He gave his perfect sinless blood.
Da nas jednog dana oslobodi od prisutnosti greha.
To free us from the presence of sin.
Ali i danas dok sedimo na vavilonskim vodama.
But today as we sit by the rivers of Babylon.
Da nas oslobodi od sile greha.
To free us from the power of sin.
Da skinemo naše lire sa mesta gde smo ih okačili.
To so we should take off our lyres from the branches where we hung them.
Da naštimujemo naša srca i da dozvolimo Isusu da ponovo stavi sionsku pesmu u našu dušu.
To tune our hearts and allow Jesus to put the song of Zion into our hearts once again.
Čitao sam o Tanji.
I read this story about a young lady named Tanja.
Ako neko ima slično ili isto ime, u redu je.
This could be any other name. If you have another name if you're in your
njen verenik David ležao je u sobi za intenzivnu negu.
Her fiance David was laying in a hospital bed in the intensive care unit.
Imao je tešku komplikovanu operaciju na mozgu.
He had had a very difficult complicated brain surgery.
Davidove oči kad god su bile otvorene, on je video Tanju.
And whenever David opened his eyes, he saw Tanja, his
fiancée. Koja nije odlazila od njega tih nekoliko dana.
Who would not leave his side for those few days.
Pomalo u čudu, David je rekao.
And he was a little puzzled.
Kako to svaki put kad otvorim oči, ja vidim da si ti tu na istom mestu?
He said, why is it that, how is it possible that every time I open my eyes, there you are in the same spot?
Ja to volim.
I like that.
Kad god sam pomislio na tebe, otvorio sam oči i video sam te da si tu.
Whenever I thought about you, I would open my eyes and there you were.
Ovo je nama potrebno dok ležimo u sobi gde se oporavljamo od posljedica greha.
This is exactly what we need while we're lying in our bed where we're recovering from the effects of sin.
I kad neka zatvorimo naše oči.
And when we close our eyes
i pomislimo na našeg Isusa,
and think of our Jesus,
kad ih otvorimo,
when we open our eyes,
prvo što vidimo to je da vidimo njega koji je tu i koji se ne miče sa toga mesta.
The first thing we see is him who never leaves our side.
Ovo je nama potrebno. Mislim da postoji jedna jako lepa pesma Ti si tu.
This is what we need. There is a beautiful song called You Are Here.
I kad pogledate na sat i mislite da ste već dovoljno slušali, ja neću da vas pustim dok vas ne odvedem u otkrivenje za posljednja 2-3 minuta.
And as we wrap up the sermon today, we're going to go to the book of Revelation.
Osjećam da bi nedostajao vrhunac.
I feel like we need some kind of a culmination, a climax.
Veličanstveni opis u otkrivenju u dva poglavlja, u 14. i u 15.
The magnificent description that we find in Revelation 14
and 15.
And 15.
Tu vidimo kako nas je Isus pokupio i doveo na Sionsku goru.
Here we see how Jesus picked us up and brought us to Mount Zion.
Ovo je epilog biblijske priče o dva grada.
This is the epilogue of the Bible story about two cities.
Vavilona i Jerusalima.
Babylon and Jerusalem.
Dolazi dan, braćo i sestre.
A day is coming, brothers and sisters.
I mi hrišćani adventisti verujemo da je vrlo brzo.
And we Adventists believe that it's approaching soon.
Kad će Isus dovesti svoju decu na goru Sionsku.
When Jesus will bring his children to Mount Zion.
Kad će Babilon definitivno biti iza nas.
When Babylon will definitely be behind us.
I onda će se kroz čitav svemir zaoriti Sionska pesma.
And then throughout the whole universe, the song of Zion will sound.
Nema više babilonskih voda.
The Babylonian rivers will be no more.
Ima reke života.
There is the river of life.
Pored koje ćemo stajati i pevati sa harfama u našim rukama.
By which we will stand and sing with harps in our hands.
Ja nisam izmislio ovu divnu sliku, ona je u Otkrivenju.
I didn't make up this wonderful scene. It's in the book of Revelation.
Šta piše u 14:1 u Otkrivenju?
What does Revelation 14:1 say?
I vidih i gle jagnje stajaše na gori Sionskoj.
Then I looked and there before me was the Lamb standing on Mount Zion.
I ko je s njim?
And who is with him?
I s njim 144,000.
And with him 144,000.
I zanimljivo je da je ime očevo na čelima njihovim.
And it's interesting that the name of the Father is on their foreheads.
I onda drugi stih kaže, i ču glas sa neba.
And then verse 2 says, and I heard a sound from heaven.
Kao glas voda mnogih.
Like the roar of rushing waters.
I kao glas groma velikoga.
And like a loud peal of thunder.
I ču glas svirača koji pevahu u svoje lire.
The sound I heard was like that of harpists playing their harp.
Ovo je vrhunac.
This is the culmination.
Ovo je ono što očekujemo.
This is what we are anticipating.
Jagnje koje je danas stalno sa nama i vidimo ga kad god otvorimo svoje oči, vidimo Hrista.
The Lamb who is with us in every single moment when we open our eyes, we see him.
Nećemo
we
više see gledati Christ. One koji su nam problem oko nas i u crkvi i kod kuće.
We're not going to see those who are a problem to us.
Ako danas gledamo jagnje stalno pored nas, onda ćemo s njim biti na gori Sionskoj.
If we're looking at the Lamb today with us all the time, then we're going to be with him on Mount Zion.
I naše harfe, naše lire će biti u našim rukama.
And our harps, our lyres will be in our hands.
I onda 15. poglavlje.
And then chapter 15.
Drugi stih.
Verse 2.
I videh kao stakleno more smešano sa ognjem.
And I saw what looked like a sea of glass mixed with fire.
I one što pobediše zveri, ikonu njezinu, i žig njezin, i broj imena njezina.
And standing beside the sea, those who had been victorious over the beast and his image and over the number of his name.
Ovo je trostruka spojenost apokaliptičkog Vavilona.
This is a triple connection of the apocalyptic Babylon.
Zveri, ikona i žig njezin.
The beast, the image of the beast and the number of the beast.
Gde stoje na moru staklenome.
They're standing on the sea, beside the sea.
I imahu
and
šta?
They held what?
Lire Božje.
They held harps given them by God.
Ta harfa.
That harp.
Nekada na drvetu.
At one point hung on the tree.
Sada je u našim rukama.
Now is in our hands.
I pevahu pesmu Mojsija, sluge Božjega.
And sang the song of Moses, the servant of God.
I pesmu jagnjeta
and the song
govoreći,
of the Lamb.
Velika su i divna dela tvoja, Gospode Bože svedržitelju.
Great and marvelous are your deeds, Lord God Almighty.
Kakav vrhunac sukoba između Vavilona i Jerusalima.
What a climax of the conflict between Babylon and Jerusalem.
Vrlo brzo naš Isus će zameniti naše vode vavilonske, vode na kojima ima mnogo suza, sa gorom Sionskom.
Very soon our Lord Jesus Christ will replace the tears, many tears shed on the rivers of Babylon with.
Zato budi siguran da budeš tamo.
So make sure that you find yourself there.
I budi siguran da poneseš svoju liru, svoju harfu.
And make sure that you have your harp with you.
Da bude u našim rukama.
Hold it in your hands.
Amen.
Amen.